Not me driving all over the grass trying to get out of the driveway. All right, what's up guys? It's Catherine and welcome back to my channel. So I know it's been like months since we've chatted. I kind of said goodbye to YouTube in June because I was just so overwhelmed with finishing up my classes for the summer and my job and TikTok, and I didn't have really the time or the energy to post to YouTube, but I just didn't have the energy no matter how much I tried. I filmed probably the entire summer and I was just like not with it. So I decided to take a break, and honestly I'm glad I did because I was able to dedicate my time to creating content on my Instagram page and on my TikTok, whereas before I felt like I had no organization when it came to content. I was never really creating anything with meaning. I was just kind of posting and doing these like little things, but towards the end of the summer in July, I started to really learn about fashion and I started to grow on TikTok, which was amazing. I had a viral video that hit like 300,000 views and I gained like 8,000 or 9,000 followers in like a month. And I was excited because like that's lit, are you kidding? And so now I just reached 13,000 yesterday and I'm so excited and so thankful that there are so many of you who want to like follow my journey and have been there through this crazy pandemic. Like it's weird to have growth during a pandemic because these people don't know me when I'm not like locked in my parents' house. And I do think that's so interesting and I can't wait until I can create content again like in the outside world and you guys can see my life and my friends. And that's really the craziest part is like when I started doing YouTube, I was vlogging with my friends and I was vlogging with my roommates and we had so many things to do. And even before that, when I was vlogging, I was doing travel vlogs when I was abroad. So I just kind of ran out of juice when it came to content and I was like, just take a break, like take a step back, reevaluate what you wanna do. And now I have so many things to share with you guys. It's literally crazy how much has happened since we've chatted. So right now I'm headed to Trader Joe's and I'm going to show you guys a little Trader Joe's haul because I'm a Trader Joe's gal. That and Whole Foods, I'm like a stan. Whole Foods, I have a hard time because every time I go there, I spend so much money and it's like disheartening. But Trader Joe's, tried and true, I always get a ton of it and it costs like nothing. So I just love supporting Trader Joe's, I'm a huge fan. I'm also getting my eyebrows laminated tonight for like the 10th time, like it's not anything new. If you haven't seen, I actually did a video called My Lamination Experience. It was my first time ever getting a lamination. And shout out to Jackie, my queen brow Beyonce, always hooking it up. Oh my God, look at the sky. Are you kidding? Okay, so I literally have no words that I just got a front row spot at Trader Joe's, but I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna go in, I'm gonna get the things I need, and I'm gonna show you guys a little bit of a sneak peek. Okay, so the lighting is really bad, but I just left Trader Joe's. I got so many goodies, and I just have to say, I absolutely love Emma Chamberlain's podcast. I think it is so good, and it's so relevant, but her podcast, I will say, is one of my favorite YouTuber podcasts, and I've been listening to it a lot. Today, I listened to the divorce episode, advice session number 7, and I can't talk to people, which is like about her social anxiety. And I just wanna say, she is doing a superb job for such a young girl who really, honestly, like sounds like she has her head on, right? Like it sounds like she knows what's going on in the world. She seems like self-aware enough to know like what's happening. I don't know. I just really think that it's really impressive for anyone who grows up in the public eye or comes to fame quickly. I think that's like really admirable when they grow up and they just like become a really great person. Obviously it's like so much works against you, like within media and people and paparazzi and fans and all that crazy shit. Like I think that her content is great and you should go check out the podcast. I think it's anything goes with Emma. It's really good, go listen. So I'm gonna fill up my car with some gas right now and then head on home, unpack my groceries, and hopefully go get my eyebrows done. Well, yeah, getting my eyebrows done because they're looking rough. I am a full train wreck right now. Like, I am not having a good time. Well, I am, but I just went to this gas station and the first pump I went to kept stopping like every 10 seconds. And I was like, what the fuck is this? So I left that pump and I went to another one and I swiped my card twice and it wasn't working. So then I had to go inside and I had to wait. And I'm like waiting in this long line and I have groceries in the back, but I got it done. And then I only put $20 in because I don't know how much the full tank was. So I only got like, oh, I'm not too far, like 267 miles, but now I gotta wait in this traffic, so I'll catch up with you guys in a bit.
So cute.
My face.
Remember that first time when I put you in my video?
I was like, hey.
You were like, delete it.
I hate the whole thing.
All right, guys, it is the next day and I got my eyebrows done last night. Yeah, they're looking incredible. Thank God I needed it. I am going to be doing a real quick little try on size 12 Princess Polly so you guys can really see what these clothes look like. I'm more of a 12/14 standard XL. Sorry, this light is so rude. Okay, whatever, I'll deal with it. But I wanted to try them on, review them, and show you guys. I did a little bit of a preview on TikTok, but this is going to be full review, full try on, and some of them are really good, some of them not so much, but I did get a lot of feedback in the comments saying that they loved them, everything was great, and I felt a little bit differently. So we're gonna try them on, and I'm gonna show you guys what I got. All right, this is dress number one. It's the Taj mini dress. It's a blue leopard print, which is literally so cute. I just bought a pair of biker shorts in this print, but overall I do think this is really cute for like a spring or a summer day, like a fun little picnic outfit, dinner, lunch kind of vibe. It's very, very cute. The only thing is like it has this weird wire under cup, which is like kind of strange, but I just love the fit of this. I do think it's very flattering and it's pretty cute. For the price, this was $18. I'm gonna pop it up on the screen. I will give this a 10 out of 10 for the price because I don't think I've ever gotten a sale item from Princess Polly that was like a hit, so good job. Next item. Okay, this is dress number two. This is the Norman mini dress in black. I'm gonna pop that on the screen. It was $43, which is a little pricey, I think, for this, because I mean, I thrift. So I could thrift a little black mini slip, but my butt is literally about to fall out of this. So I don't think I could wear this. I'm 5'3". Like, I'm pretty short, and this slit is a little bit high, I will say. Like, this could be doable, but the problem for me is that the back is so short, and I mean, even my bralette. Like, I think this is a very pretty dress, but for the price, the quality feels very cheap to me. I don't know why, it just feels really thin and doesn't really feel, like, literally when I turn around, I feel like my butt is completely out. So this, I don't know, the comments went crazy on this one. People loved this dress, and I do think it's really cute. Like, this is a very like trendy piece right now. Like, a lot of people probably bought this dress, which is cute, but for my size, like, this is a little, I don't know, a lot of people said it's very flattering, which I really appreciate, and I think that's very sweet, but I do feel like it's really short. I can feel butt falling out, so I'm gonna go with like a 5 or 6 out of 10, just for me. The price, the quality, it wasn't there. It is very cute though. I will be trying to thrift a piece like this, so that tells you something. I'm down with that. All right, so this is the Sherry mini dress in green. To me, it looks more yellow, but I like this dress in theory, but also the same, the back. It's shorter in the back than it is the front, which like literally makes no sense to me how the back could be this little fabric. I really do like the details. To me, it feels very see-through. Like, you can see my underwear, you can see my bralette. It's a little too much for me. I really wanted this to work though, because I think that this would be so cute and I've seen a lot of people wear this. I think this would like definitely suit a lot of girls, but for me, it doesn't fit my size. It just doesn't feel very, I don't know. I wanna love this dress, but because it's so see-through, it like makes me uncomfortable. But I styled it with obviously white sneakers and a little black bag. I really wanted this to work too, so I'm kind of sad. Like, I saw this all over the website, and girls looked so cute, and I really wanted it to be cute on me, but I don't know. This just like did not go off. I wish it wasn't see-through. If it was a thicker material and a little longer in the back, like, look at this. That's my butt. All right, I'm gonna give this one like a 7.5. All right, so on to the next item. All right, next item is the tahini mini dress. This is also a size 12. Okay, so my problem with this dress, in theory, this would be perfect dress, like love, but we've got a boob problem. So the little cup moment is very, very small, and there's no, like these straps are full stretch, so like there's no support there. Like, it is very cute though, like it's a little short as well, but the print is beautiful. It's a lot thicker material, but I'd love to wear it, but I just can't. I can't do the front. Like, it's too much. But, oh, the material is beautiful. This was, I think, yeah, this was $40. A little bit on the pricier side, but I would say if you have a smaller bust, this is a go-to. Like, this is very cute. I like that the slit is larger, but it also has, like, coverage. Like, it's not fully open. I don't know. The print is also very beautiful. It's got, like, little red flowers. Very cute. In a different universe, this would be a moment for me. All right, on to our final piece. All right, the final piece, this is the Penelope mini dress in black. Let me tell you, the size 12 is not mini. That is my biggest concern about this dress, that it is so long. If I rolled it to like my own length, it would be like right here. So I actually shot some Instagram pictures, and I'll pop those up there so you can see how I styled it. I wore Spanx because it has to be done sometimes. And there's just so much material, which is fine. If there was like a tie or like a ruched side where you could like loosen it, like this is so long. Like, I'm 5'3" and a half and my legs are so short, I can never, like, I feel so stubby in this. But this is like the perfect style. This is exactly what I wanted. I saw it and I was like, this is amazing. I've seen people wear this on Instagram. Okay, problem. There was a white torn seam on the sleeve, which you can see, and I didn't pull it, I didn't touch it, I left it there. But overall, this is like really long for a dress. So yesterday I like tucked it into my Spanx and tried to make it a little bit more mini dress. I paired it with like a gold diamond chain and some little hoop earrings, some rings, and it's a beautiful dress. And the material is very thick and full coverage. It feels like a sweater, like a knitted kind of moment, which is super cute. But if it was not an extra like 5 or 6 inches long, like this goes almost like, like, this is way too long for my height. It's a beautiful dress and I'm sad. Like, I really wanted this one to work. I even thought about keeping it and getting it tailored. But for the price, $45, I think I'm gonna look elsewhere. Probably try to thrift one. But this is my little review. But I wanted to try on some items. I wanted to give Princess Polly a shot because a lot of their stuff doesn't ever fit me well. And I don't know if it's whether just my specific body type. Obviously, they're not very size inclusive. They only go up to a US 12, but I figured it was worth a shot. I know they've added models to their website that were size 6 and 8 now, which is cool. I'm glad they've got a little bit more diversity versus like a 0 or 2, which was more standard on their site before. However, their items still don't fit me. So a little sad about that one. I'm going to be keeping the first dress that I tried on, which was my favorite. And it was on sale, it was $18, but this one is gonna have to go back. I'm hoping I will find a new one. If you guys have any recommendations for a dress like this, maybe from a boutique, or maybe you saw one on Depop or something like that, let me know because I'm really interested in buying one. And thank you guys for watching. I'm glad to be back on YouTube. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. My hair is so greasy and I need to get it washed real bad today. But I wanted to do a little try on. So thank you guys for watching. Go subscribe to my channel, go follow my Instagram. I'm working on a secret project right now. It is Deck the Label on Instagram. I'm gonna pop that up right here. I'm developing a sustainably packaged streetwear brand company. And I have a drop collection coming very soon, hopefully the end of the month. I will keep you guys in the loop. I will keep you guys updated. And thanks so much for watching. If you missed me, leave a comment down below and tell me that I need to post every Saturday for the rest of my life. Okay, thanks. Bye.